welcome to the FNTV show, video podcast.
What's up, guys? I'm here with Steven Wilcox and Dan's promoter. Welcome to the FNTV show, video podcast. This is episode one. We're doing it big for episode one. Here, the professional fighter and his promoter, straight out from Canada.
All right, so I'm Dan Otter. I'm operations manager for 3lions.
Family,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, yeah. The dad's the coach to boot, eh?
Oh, so you guys know. I'm the dad's the coach. All right.
really just show you, we keep that big brother.
Exactly. I was just gonna say that. So as Steve said, he has a brother in Jesse, which me and Jesse fought, I think, back in, what was it?
2010?
Yeah, it must have been 2010. We fought in Panama, for the Panama, Pan-American Trials. So that was a real good fight. I really enjoyed that fight with Jesse. I don't think we've ever had a conversation on his thoughts of the fight, or my thoughts of the fight, but I definitely look forward to fight Jesse again if I was still in the ring. Because I enjoyed it, but it was a real good fight. My thing with Jesse was, he was real long.
They're all built as boxers.
Yeah, man, I gave me such a hard time. I'm a quick fighter, you know. Speed's my thing. But, man, his length just really gave me a real hard time in that fight, man. It just gave me a real hard time. So, I had to, you know, I like to counter a lot. But I had to change my whole complete game plan and just try to pressure fight Jesse.
Get inside.
He's just so tall, you know. It was difficult, so. Shout out to Jesse.
Make sure to Jesse.
We're waiting on you to get down here.
Yeah. We're gonna do some sparring matches. He wants a piece.
But man, I'm 100%. You know, I was talking on the phone, so 100% behind you. I said, keep up the good work, man. He said 8-0 right now.
8-0, yeah. He should be 9-0, but he got a headbutt two fights ago. Cut his eye in the third round, so it's no contest.
So Dan, you're doing an amazing job.
Thank you, man.
Real quick on the Mayweather McGregor fight, because I know everybody want to hear from your standpoint.
I thought, I'm not gonna lie, it's what I expected. No, I give it to Conor. He did a little better, you know, the first 40.
Surprised me too.
But then you know, a lot of people are like, oh, Conor, he's gonna get him, he's gonna get him. And I was like, there's no way.
Yeah,
you know what I mean, that's Floyd's way of fighting. You know, he's a cold. He starts off slow, and he's a genius in the ring, right? Like
it
don't matter how good you are, he'll figure you out.
For sure.
Well, many of the fights, how many times you know Floyd would fight, and you're like, shit, this guy's gonna give him. You know, he's giving him trouble. He's giving him.
You look at him and Shane Mosley.
Yeah,
exactly.
I think I thought even Mosley was gonna knock him out.
I thought so too.
One punch shots.
Exactly.
But it was good. It was entertainment, right? And I light on boxing. I'm happy that we got, you know, entertainment.
But I'm happy it's over.
I'm happy it's over.
I'm happy. Social media and stuff, you know, get back to us. You know,
real stuff. Real stuff. Triple G and Canelo.
That's a real fight.
Every single day, like religiously, like I couldn't pass a day without watching it.